Tonight, for the District 5, we have three candidates, Mr. Chandon Adams, Justin Hawkins, and Laura Semanson. And we've gone over the time previous, and they know the time. We have timekeepers up here in the front that's keeping track of that, and Joel Natt's doing the moderating for this one more time. And before we end and turn it over to them, just a reminder, School Board District 3 on April 25th, and School Board District 5 on April 25th. That one starts at 6, and the second one starts at 7:30 back here at this location. So hopefully y'all will be able to join us for that. So without that, I'll turn it over to Joel Natt.
Good evening again. Right before the debate, they all drew numbers to start. Easier, a little more difficult than a coin toss, unfortunately. Mr. Hawkins won, and he will go first with his introduction, followed by Mr. Adams, and finally, and I'm terribly sorry I'm going to mutilate your name the first time I said, so help me with it, Laura?
Laura Semanson.
Semanson. Thank you. And then finally, Ms. Monson will finish up with the introductions. Mr. Hawkins, you get to go first. You have 2 minutes to do your introduction.
I'm recovering of allergies, so please forgive me. I want to thank everybody for coming out tonight. And Joel, I want to thank you and the Republican Party for hosting this debate, and also Shannon and Laura. Thank you for participating. The main reason why I'm running for commissioner is very simple. I believe Forsyth County is at a critical crossroad. See, I was raised in the heart of South Forsyth. I'm a product of this school system. Congested roads, overcrowded schools, and getting hit with out-of-control growth is not something I learned about on social media, researched on the internet. I lived it. When we talk about kids going to schools in trailers, when we talk about eating on the hallway floor and in a cafeteria, I did it. Right now, we've had out-of-control growth plague Forsyth County. We've had to increase property taxes 3 times, and our county leaders had to acquire over $800 million in debt. Right now, District 5 needs a commissioner who has the leadership, the vision, the experience to protect the quality of life, to preserve this community, and to give the citizens a seat at the table. On May 24th, I ask for your vote, but just know I'll work very hard to earn it. Thank you very much.
Next question is to you, Mr. Hawkins. What is your experience with preparing and authorizing budgets?
Well, first off, I was the treasurer for the Forsyth County Republican Party last year, and I actually had a great time working with you all, and that absolutely prepared me to handle the budget. I mean, we handle thousands of dollars year end. We have expenses, and we need to make sure that our revenue doesn't exceed our expenses. Our expenses don't exceed our revenue. And the fact of the matter is, we need someone qualified not only to handle the budget, but someone also has the experience of handling the growth. I'm the only one on this stage that has experience on both sides of the aisle in the matters of zoning. I've negotiated with commissioners on one side, I've negotiated with commissioners protecting the citizens. And so we need someone who absolutely, we don't need on-the-job training, we cannot afford it. Forsyth County right now is at a critical crossroad. We cannot afford on-the-job training. We need people qualified right now.
To try to claim that there's some benefit of experience when you're 25 years old, I think that's a pretty bold statement. Huh?
Mr. Hawkins, any rebuttal?
Well, I was the treasurer and handled thousands of dollars for this very party to get this room to host this debate. So, I mean, if we didn't have a treasurer that was responsible, we wouldn't be able to do these things. At 25, I'm the only one that actually has experience in negotiating the deals that are oppressive. Out of control growth, would you agree, is the number one issue? I think so. I don't think you've negotiated any sort of those deals. So I think that, yeah, I'm 25, I embrace that. I grew up here. I was raised by a single mother, the oldest of 5 children. I negotiated those deals. I know exactly what to do on day one.
I would say also that I kind of challenge the notion that you're opposed to the high density growth, because I have seen your very own words supporting it, and I'm just concerned that you actually do support the Res 6s and the apartments and those types of things.
Well, there's no doubt anybody that knows me knows that I work for the most effective zoning attorney in the entire county. And they have a skill set to achieve results. I knew that's not what I wanted to be. I didn't want to become a zoning attorney. I went into pharmaceutical sales, worked for Johnson & Johnson. But after I became a private citizen, I also negotiated on the other way. I've negotiated for the overlay district. I've negotiated now for the Habersham sewer to be acquired by the city. I've negotiated on both sides of the aisle. And the fact of the matter is, people hire defense attorneys. Why? Or most defense attorneys have been prosecutors. Because you need to know how the other side works.
Please, no comments from the audience. Thank you.
Mr. Hawkins, the next question is to you. What is your position on the creation of any additional cities within the county?
I was raised in the heart of South Forsyth. I've lived there. I grew up in Three Chimneys. I live in James Creek now. I totally understand why the citizens want to bring back local control. I think it's a shame they didn't get a chance to vote on it this year. I hope they get a chance to vote on it soon.
Mr. Hawkins.
I want to thank you, Joel, and the Republican Party again for hosting this. I want to thank the people for coming out. Listen, I've said it over and over again. I'll say it again. I'm from South Forsyth. I went to Dave's Creek Elementary. I went to South Forsyth Middle School and graduated from South Forsyth High School. I grew up in the neighborhood that Laura lives in, Three Chimneys, and I currently live in James Creek. I understand this community because it built me. I understand the fabric of what makes us great. The fact of the matter is, we are at a critical crossroad. We've been inundated with high density zonings, and we've had to increase property taxes three times in our military, acquire over $800 million in debt. What will Rock County look like in 20 years? I want to live here for the next 20 and 30, not 5 or 10. So I have, I think, a long-term investment in this community.
For your time tonight, Mr. Mock.
Thank y'all again for coming out. Let's give these candidates another round of applause. And Joel, let's also give Joel and Natt, our moderator, it's a tough job to be the moderator. The next room, April 25th, is School Board District 3 and District 5, and early voting starts May 2nd. So please mark that on your calendar if you'd like to get out there early. So thank you all for coming out.
And everybody needs to be registered to vote by next Tuesday.